Welcome to Facebook and on the line. I'm Dr. Neil. How you doing this morning? We will be saved. They cried unto the Lord and he saved them. Are y'all getting any rain down there yet? Thinking you all in Florida because you're on the borderline.
He was filled with the Holy Ghost. Open up your hearts and let Jesus come in. He will wash away every sin. Jesus is, he's the Son of God. Oh yes, Jesus is, he's the Son of God. For the Holy Ghost will tell you so. Jesus come in, he will fill you once again.
Yes, Jesus is, he's the Son of God. Oh yes, Jesus is, he's the Son of God.
Just step away for a second and cut this off. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we come right now in the name of Yeshua the Messiah. And God, I bless your name this morning. God, I thank you, oh God, for allowing me to see another day. God, I thank you, O God, for all that you have done in our lives and all that you continue to do. God, I thank you for your mercy, your grace, your long-suffering, your patience, your kindness. God, I thank you that you're never too far away when we call upon the name of the Lord. God, I bless you for sending your Son this morning that we could have life and we could have it more abundantly. God, I thank you for sending your Son to heal those who are sick, to heal those who are being afflicted by Satan. God, I thank you. I thank you, O God, for your mercy endures forever throughout all generation. God, I thank you because your grace is sufficient for every need for those who are followers of Yeshua the Messiah. God, I ask you to move by your Spirit this morning. Touch each and every one of us, O God, in the name of Yeshua. Give us a heart of flesh, O God, that we will hear your word, we will receive your word, and we will act on your word. God, I ask you to move by your Spirit, O God, and calm the storm that they are speaking of, O God, that is coming through different areas, oh God. Oh God, send it out to sea in the name of Yeshua. Let it not be a hurricane for, oh God, but reduce it, oh God, to just rain. God, let no one harm be destroyed, no one animals be destroyed, no floods in their home, oh God. Send it in a different direction, oh God, in the name of Yeshua. And God, we pray, oh God, for this fighting and the bombing going on, oh God. We pray, oh God, that there would be no more bombing, oh God, in the name of Yeshua, that you would protect those people, oh God, in the name of Yeshua, that you would bring them out safely, oh God, in the name of Yeshua. Oh God, take out the heart of murder, oh God. Let those people know that your word says, thou shalt not kill, he that kills shall be killed, in the name of Yeshua. God, let them know that this is not of you, but it's of evil. It is of the spirit of Satan. So God, we ask you to move in a mighty way in the name of Yeshua. Send your angels over there to give them charge over the people, God. When they come in to do evil, God, send them back a different way, oh God, in the name of Yeshua. God, you said we could bring all our cares unto you, for you care for us. And God, I bless you and I thank you in advance for just moving by your Holy Spirit in the name of Yeshua. I give you praise. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you all for joining me this morning. Good morning, Pearline. Good to see you this morning. Hallelujah. Seems like we're getting a little slow start this morning. First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you who was praying for the family as we traveled to Florida last week and praying for my daughter. And praise God, I can say this morning she is doing well. In case you're wondering how she's doing, she's a strong woman and she's doing well. But continue to pray for the family in the name of Yeshua. Even though we see smiles, we know sometimes there's still sadness. But we know Yeshua came to do what? Wash away our tears and give us joy unspeakable. As I said to someone, you know, we are not there yet, but the Bible teaches us we should rejoice when someone leaves this world. And when a baby is born, that's when we should cry. But I always say we're not there yet. But then I was reminded of David. When his son was sick, he prayed and he mourned for his sons. His friend went and just sat there with him while he was in mourning. But once he passed, his pain went away. He got up and went on to do the will of the Lord. So that let us know, you know, we pray when there is a chance for God to move by his spirit and heal and deliver and make free. But once it's over, it's over. It's nothing we can do because we all are passing through. And one day we will also leave this world. But we know in order to end up in a better place, we must be in Yeshua the Messiah, and we must be followers of Yeshua the Messiah. That's why I give out the seed when I come on. Every time I come on, every time I go off, and every once in a while I might forget. Shall be saved. Mark 16:16, he that believeth, he that continue to believe and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. Then we go to Proverbs 28:13, he that confesses and forsaketh his sin shall have mercy. He that confesses and forsaketh not his sin will not prosper. First John 1 and 9, if we confess our sins, He faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So that let us know, in order to be forgiven of sin, we must come clean. We must acknowledge our sins. As David says, I acknowledge my sins. My sins is always before me, but we know when we are in Yeshua the Messiah, once we own up to it, acknowledge it, and forsake, turn away from it, it's no longer in front of us, it's not behind us, it's not on the side of us, it's washed away by the blood of Yeshua the Messiah. And remember, Yeshua says what? I will thoroughly cleanse my floor. That means He want to thoroughly cleanse our hearts, which means our hearts get filthy because of sin. Our hearts get filthy because of evil deeds, evil work, work of the flesh. That's what makes us unclean. When you go to, I'm thinking Matthew 20, I'm not looking at it, maybe Matthew 20, maybe 23, I'm not looking at it right now. But the Bible teaches us what defiles a man. And the Bible let us know what defiles us. It's not what go into us, it what come out of us. Which means we can eat food, it will not defile us. It might kill us because it's not good for us. But sin go into our hearts and it comes out. Other words, many times sin can come into us, but we can cast it right back out. It's kind of like you pour water in a glass or you pour soda in a glass. You taste it, you don't like it, no good, not good for me, and you just throw it out. Well, you didn't drink it, you just taste it, but you got rid of it because it wasn't good for you. Well, sin, Satan brings sin to us to try to get it in our hearts. But we can cast it out. That's why when we are tempted by Satan, that doesn't mean we sin because we thought something. Because you're tempted by your mind. It was go into your mind. In other words, if Yeshua had sinned, that means he would have acted out what Satan was trying to get him to do. But the Bible let us know Yeshua never sinned. But guess what? He was also tested by Satan. That let me know, because I'm tested by Satan, that doesn't mean I sin. It may be a sinful thing I'm being tried by. But the only way I sin is when I act on it. And that's why when things come into our minds, into our hearts, that's not good for us, for our spirit, we're to cast them out. And so never think because a thought came to your mind, you sin. Many people think you sin. No, because they use the scripture where the Bible says, if a man look on a woman, which means that means he got to keep looking, not look and look away. He already sinned. And so that doesn't mean he sinned because he just looked. But if he continued to look, that means he's going to act on it. Or the woman, if she continued to look, sooner or later, they're going to act on it. So those are sinful thought, but it doesn't mean we sin unless we keep thinking about it and then we act it out. Hallelujah. Now to the Word of God. We were continuing with this study a couple of weeks ago. Some of the subject or titles, if you want to say, is what we're going to cover. A spring, meaning fountain, open up to cleanse from sin and impurity. False prophet, shame. We had that statement out there a few weeks. We just never got there. If you knew God, yes, you cannot continue to live because you are speaking lies. The fountain of life. Continue your grace to those who know you and your righteousness. Springs of living water. As we said, I've been sharing this particular scripture every week when I'm on. Welcome the message and examine the scripture every day to see if the things said and taught are true. And you find that statement in Acts chapter 17 and verse 11. Also, we're online in case if you have a question, you're welcome to call me. If you have a prayer request, you're welcome to call me. I'll post them on Facebook as well. And the number is out there, 712-775-7031, when prompt, 294-147-pound. Now to the teaching. A spring fountain will be opened up to cleanse from sin and impurity. Well, when you think of a spring and a fountain, you're thinking of water, right? Well, we know the Word of God is also cleansing. But when we continue to study, we will see who the spring and this fountain is. False prophet again, shame. Zechariah 13, we finished Zechariah's chapter number 12, I'm thinking. And this is where we stopped off a couple of weeks ago. So this is Zechariah 13, reading from the Complete Jewish Bible. Will tell you if I change. When that day come, a spring will be opened up for the house of David and the people living in Jerusalem to cleanse them from sin and impurity. Well, we know when we are baptized, that also like a what? A cleansing. When we get the Spirit of God in us and catch the spirit of Satan out of us, that's like what? A cleansing. The Word of God does what? Cleanses us. So Zacharias again, 13, when that day comes, a spring will be opened up for the house of David and the people living in Jerusalem to cleanse them from sin and impurity. A spring, a fountain. Thessalonians 4:7. What we are focusing on this word, cleansing. 1 Thessalonians 4:7, Complete Jewish Bible. But God did not call us to live an unclean life, but a holy one. Well, this is what God called us to do. Remember, He's going to open up a fountain to cleanse us from sin and impurity. Why? Because God did not call us to live an unclean life, but a holy one. James 1:21, reading from AMP. So get rid of all uncleanness and all that remain of wickedness, and with a humble spirit. Root it in your heart, which is able to save your soul. Now, when someone hear that, if they don't focus on it, they may think this means unbeliever. No, this has to do with those of us who are in Yeshua the Messiah. How do we know? Let's look at it again. Get rid of all uncleanness and all that remain of wickedness, and with a humble spirit, receive the word of God, which is implanted. Notice that. Implanted, because many times the word is implanted, engraved in our hearts. Actually, rooted in your heart. See, that let us know, well, we know unbelievers, they can get rid of certain things, and they may have the word of God in their hearts. But if they are not in Yeshua the Messiah, it doesn't matter what they do, but they will never enter into the kingdom of God. Because you can't run a race unless you are in the race. If you're out of the race, you can't run it. So those of us who are in Yeshua, we have the word of God many times implanted in our hearts, rooted in our hearts. Well, let you know is the word of God, which is able to save your soul and able to save my soul. Well, remember, we will say God is able. Yes, God is able to do more than we can imagine or think. God is able, but it doesn't mean God is going to do what he's able to do all the time, because it's depend on us. God is able to turn that hurricane out to sea. God is able to receive that water back where it came from. You notice that when it moves over warm water, that's where it get its strength. So God is able. God is able to remove those evil spirit out of those people that's killing people. God is able to move hatred out of our hearts. God is able to heal the sick. He's able to do everything and anything, but that doesn't mean he's going to do it because he's able. Why? Because of his word is written and is settled in heaven. So these certain things are going to come to pass. God is able to save everyone, but everyone will not be saved. God is able to deliver everyone, but everyone will not be delivered, because the Bible says God will is that all be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. But that doesn't mean all going to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. Why? Because it's up to each individual, because these things will come to pass. But we can allow Yeshua to come in our hearts, and then he can do all things, but it's up to us. Are we willing? God is able, but are we willing? Yeshua is able, but are we willing? The word is there, but are we going to receive it? We may receive it, but will we act on it? Either way, the Bible says the word is able. Not that it's going to save everybody's soul, but it's able to save your soul. It's able to save my soul. But how can it save my soul? I must receive it, and I need to do what? Obey it. I'm not reading 2 Peter chapter number 2. I have many times. Went back and read it, the whole chapter again yesterday. But you might want to read 2 Peter chapter number 2 to get a good understanding of the word we just spoke of. The fountain of life. The fountain of life. Well, who is the fountain of life? Let's find out. Psalm 36 and 9, reading from King James Version. For with thee. Now, if you're reading your Bible, you might want to highlight some words, or go back and do it later. For with you, with who? With God. For with you is the fountain of life. Who is the fountain of life? Yeshua. Because Yeshua was with his Father from the foundation of the world. So let's look at it again. For with thee, God, is the fountain of life, Yeshua. In thy light, remember, God is light. Yeshua became a light, and Yeshua command us to be what? Lights. So again, for with thee, God, is the fountain of life, Yeshua. In thy light shall we see light. See, we are to be able to see light, and we are to become what? Light. Remember, Yeshua said, you are the light of the world. As God is light, Yeshua became a light, so we are to become what? Lights. And so when we are lights, what do? We outshine darkness. But if we out of Yeshua, guess what? The light goes off. But as long as we are in Yeshua, our light continue to shine. That's why when people look at us, they should see something different about us. When people look at us, they should know that there's something different about her than when I knew her 20 years ago, because we should not be the same. We should be coming more light. We should let our light shine so man can see our good work and glorify our Father in heaven. I always say the best thing someone can say to me is, I see Yeshua Jesus in you. That's the best compliment anyone can get. You know, you can say someone look good. Well, tomorrow they may look horrible. But you want your light to shine so people can see Yeshua in you. You know how sometimes we say, well, I'm a believer, or I'm saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and someone's standing on the side said, well, I can't see it. I can't tell the difference. You're the same as you was when I knew you 20 or 30 years ago. I don't see no change. I don't see no growth because our light is not shining. What's happening? Darkness is shining instead of the light. So AMP reading the same verse, Psalm 26 and 9. For with you again is the fountain of life, the fountain of life-giving water. Remember, Yeshua is the one that give us what? Life-giving water. In your light, we see light. Continue your grace to those who know you and your righteousness. Now, read that again. Continue your grace to those who what? Know you and your righteousness. Psalm 36, 10, and 12. For with you is the fountain of life. In your life we see light. Continue your grace to those who know you and your righteousness. Again, a spring, a fountain. Genesis 49, verse 22. Excuse me, getting itchy throat. Genesis 19:22, complete Jewish Bible. Joseph is a fruitful plant by spring with branches climbing over the wall. I read that again. Joseph is a fruitful plant by a spring with branches climbing over the wall. Well, remember, Jacob had what? Jacob had 12 sons, but it doesn't mention the other 11. It only mentioned Joseph is that fruitful plant that was planted, and his branches climbing. That means his branches kept growing, as our fruit are to what? Keep producing, as a good tree produce what? Good fruit. Joseph's branch run over the wall, influencing others. That AMP. Joseph's branches ran over the wall, influencing others. So we are to influence others. We are to help other people to grow. We are to help other people to be a light. People should see our light, and they want to be what? They want to be a light. Spring of living water. Revelation 7:17. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will shepherd them, will lead them to springs of living water, and God will wipe every tear from their eyes. Read that again. And he, oh, go back up. For the Lamb at the center, Yeshua the Messiah, Jesus Christ, at the center of the throne, will shepherd them. Yeshua is to be our good shepherd. Remember, he said, I am the good shepherd. Will lead them to springs of living water. And God will wipe every tear from their eyes. Other words, in heaven, there will be no crying, because God gonna wipe every tear from our eyes. In heaven, there will be no dying, because we will live forever. Revelation 21 and 6. And he said to me, it is done. I am the A and the Z, the beginning and the end. To anyone who is thirsty, I myself will give water free of charge from the fountain of life. Other words, notice he says, if anyone who is thirsty. Well, remember the Bible said, he that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be what? Shall be filled. So here it says, to anyone who is thirsty. Are you thirsty for the word of God? That's why this morning I kind of changed the title about or if you're hungry for the word of God, then I can't remember what else I put there, brunch, right? Which is the word of God. But if we're hungry, because if you're hungry for the word of God, it doesn't matter how the word of God sounds, you're going to receive it. If you're not hungry for the word of God, you're only going to receive what makes you feel good, because you're not hungry. So if I'm hungry, no matter what someone say to me, as long as truth, I might not like it at first, but I'm going to be like Ezekiel. When I first tasted it, it was bitter. But once it went down into my stomach, it became sweet as a honeycomb. So that's what happens when you're thirsty for the word of God, although you hear it and you get upset, and then you say, well, I'm not going to go back on the Facebook anymore. Oh, I'm not going to go back to that church anymore, because every time I go there, they say something that make me angry or doesn't help me feel any better. Now, if it's the truth, that means we're not hungry. So if it's not the truth, that's understandable. But we are to always receive truth no matter how it make us feel. So again, to anyone who is thirsty, I myself will give water free of charge from the fountain of life. In other words, God doesn't charge us for his spirit. He doesn't charge us for his word. But we know people write books, people write Bibles, and they have to sell them to make money to keep making more. But God's word is free. That's why we are to receive it. He said, I will give it to you without what? Without charge. We remember Yeshua said, now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. That's coming from Matthew chapter number 15. So if you haven't read that chapter, please do so. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Other words, when you hear the word of God, you receive the word of God cleanses us. So we are cleansed through that word. Ephesians 5:26, Complete Jewish Bible. In order to set it apart for God, making it clean through immersion in the word, so to speak, AMP. So that he might sanctify the church, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word of God. See that? I'll read it again. So that he might, not that he will, because it's up to us to receive it and act on it. So that he might sanctify the church, which means the body of the Messiah, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word of God. So there's a washing of water and the washing of the word. John 4:7-9. A woman from Samaria came to draw some water, and Yeshua said to her, give me a drink of water. His disciples had gone into town to buy food. The woman from Samaria said to him, how is it that you, a Jew, ask for water from me, a woman of Samaria? For a Jew doesn't associate with people from Samaria. Well, we kind of went through this quite some time ago. I'm not sure on Monday or Sunday. But here we see that the Jews didn't have anything to do with the Samaria. Well, we see that today. Sometimes the Baptist doesn't have anything to do with the Pentecostal and vice versa. Or the Catholic doesn't have anything to do with the Methodist or whatever. So we see these things been going on from the foundation of the world, but it's not to be that way. Now notice what Yeshua said. If you knew God's gift, I'm going to say that again. If you knew God's gift, well, who is God's gift? Yeshua. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whomsoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So Yeshua is that gift. If you do not believe it, let's keep reading. Yeshua is a free gift from God, the everlasting Heavenly Father. Verse number 10. Yeshua answered her, if you knew God's gift, that is, who it is saying to you, that means him, give me a drink of water, then you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water. She said to him, sir, you don't have a bucket, and the well is deep. So where do you get this living water? You aren't greater than our father Jacob. Showing again, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are our forefather. So she said, you aren't greater than our father Jacob, are you? So she asking him a question. Prove, if you have a question, ask the Lord. Don't ask everybody else because they may give you the wrong answer. You can ask someone else, but make sure you ask the Lord so you can get the correct answer. He gave us this well, meaning Jacob gave them that well, and drink from it. Jacob drank from the well. And so did his sons and his cattle. Yeshua answered, everyone who drinks this water will get thirsty again. Well, we know when we drink this water, we do get thirsty. But we have to continue to do what? Continue to drink so we will not get thirsty. So look what he says again. Let's see what he says. Yeshua answered, everyone who drinks this water will get thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water I will give him will never be thirsty again. Now, some people may say, Yeshua said if you just drink one time, you'll never get thirsty. No, you got to look at the word. But whoever drinks, the same way you continue to drink water so you will not get thirsty, you must continue to drink the word of God so you will not get thirsty. Because if you do not continue to drink the word of God, guess what? You're going to get thirsty. You're going to start losing that which you once had. You say, what do you mean? Remember Yeshua said, he that has, more will be given. He that has not, even that little he has, will be taken away. That means you start forgetting that which you knew. You start forgetting and start not acting on what you once knew. Because it being what? Taken away. Have you ever heard someone say, wow, I used to remember that scripture, but I can't remember it anymore. I once remember that song, but I can't remember it anymore. So you start to lose. Kind of remind me when I practice on my guitar, I get certain keys, I get certain chords, chords, I get certain notes, and if I don't continue, guess what? I forget. So in order to not forget, you must continue to put it in you. In other words, you will forget. That's why we forget the word of God and we forget some things that we started. On the contrary, the water I give him will become, notice that, it's going to become, the water I give him will become a spring of water where? Inside him, welling up into eternal life. That means you got to keep drinking, and then it become a spring where it's continue to flow unto eternal life. Well, you know, eternal life is a promise. We're not there yet. But we can have it, but we can lose it, whether we believe it or not. That's why the Bible teaches us in Romans chapter 7 again, verses 1 through 3, this is eternal life, that they may know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. And so he goes on. So she says in verse 15, sir, give me this water. The woman said to him, so that I won't have to be thirsty and keep coming here to draw water. Other words, she kept going to Jacob's well to draw water so she wouldn't get thirsty. So she telling Yeshua, asking Yeshua, give me this one, the one that you're speaking of, so I don't have to keep coming here to draw water. Well, Many people go to church to get filled with the Spirit. Many people go to church to get the Word of God. That's okay. But you keep going there to get the Word of God when you can get the Word of God right where you are. When you go to church, you should be taking the Word with you, not leaving it, getting it at the church and leaving it at the church. It's like the Bible. You take it to church, you bring it back. Yes, we should go to church. That's good. That's what we're having today, church, whether you believe it or not. It may not be a lot of people saying, yeah, hallelujah, praise the Lord, thank you, Jesus. But anytime you're using the Word of God, you are having church. Hallelujah. Church is us. This is the church Yeshua coming back for. Don't get me wrong. We should go to church. The Bible said, forsake not the assembly of others. So I'm not saying that. But many of us are going to church to get the Word, and then we leave the Word right there. No, you go to church, you get the Word, bring the Word back, and then make sure you're studying the Word to see what you heard at church is in the Word. Truth is always where? In the Word of God. Hallelujah. Sir, give me this water, the woman said to him, so that I won't have to be thirsty and keep coming here to draw water. Well, that's what we do. We keep going somewhere to get a word, where we can get the word right where we are. The word is nigh thee, even in your mouth. The word is nigh thee. When you're reading your Bible, the word is in front of you. So you don't have to wait to go someplace to get a word. Just open up your Bible and get a word. Then you know the word you're getting is from God, not from man's mouth, because man is giving out words that sometimes has nothing to do with God. Make sure you study the Word of God so you won't go astray. Many people are going astray because they are listening to people and not listening to the Word of God. Hallelujah. Again, sir, give me this water, the woman said to him. Everybody say to the Lord, Lord, give me your water so I don't have to keep going here and there to drink, but let the word be in me, become a spring of water, which means keep flowing, and you keep growing, keep cleansing, and you keep growing. Hallelujah. False prophet expelled. We're going to get there. We had that subject out there for weeks now. False prophets expel, and the spirit of uncleanness from the land. That means we were speaking of false prophets. Go back and read the chapter. I think it was chapter 12 we was in. False prophets going to be expelled. God going to show them up. And the spirit of uncleanness from the land. That's Zechariah 13 and 2. When that day comes, says Adonai Zaoth, I will cut off the very name of the idols from the land, so that no one even remember them anymore. I will also expel the false prophets and the spirit of uncleanness from the land. Well, we have a lot of false prophets, false teachers, false preachers, false prophetess, false evangelists, false leaders. Notice what he said. I will cut the very name of the idol, because some of us idol people become our idols. They should not be our idols. The Bible said, imitate God. Don't imitate man. Imitate God. That's why I would never try to preach like anybody else. I would never try to sing like anybody else. I would never try to pray like anybody else, because I'm not to imitate man. I'm to be an imitator of God. I am to follow God. Yeshua is my light. Yeshua followed his father. And if we're in Yeshua, we're to follow Yeshua. And when we're following Yeshua, we are following his father as well. He is our perfect example. Hallelujah. He goes on and said, I will also expel. That means I'm going to get rid of them. I'm going to show them up. I will also expel the false prophet and the spirit of uncleanness from the land. Other words, there are a lot of uncleanness out there. But he says he's going to get rid of the false prophet and the spirit of uncleanness. You cannot continue to live because you are speaking lies. You cannot continue to live for God when you are speaking lies. You don't even have to be a prophet. You could be a lay person. You could be a pastor, a teacher, evangelist, or whatever. You cannot continue to live spiritually because you are speaking lies. Remember, no liar with what? The well in my sight. Thou shalt not lie. Hallelujah. I tell people I hate lying spirits. I really do. Because I can't trust people when they lie to me. Verse 3. So that if anyone continue to prophesy, his own father and mother who brought him into the world will tell him, you cannot continue to live because you are speaking lies in the name of Adonai, name of the Lord. Then his own father and mother who brought him into the world will stab him to death. Now, people, don't say, if my son and my daughter are prophesying lies in the name of the Lord, I should stab them to death. This is when you rightly divide the word of truth. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt do no murder. Kill and be killed. Judgment is mine, says the Lord. I will repay. But back there at that time, this is when you rightly divide the word of truth. But the part you cannot live because you're speaking lies, that is for today. Because Yahshua said, no liar will dwell in my sight. Hallelujah. He that lie, let him lie no more. Psalms 101:7. No deceitful person, liar, can live in my house. No liar can be my advisor. AMP. He who practices deceit will not dwell in my house. That means you're going to be taken out of the family of God. He who tell lies and half truths will not continue to remain in my presence. Zechariah 13:14. Again, when that day come, each one of the prophet will be shamed by his vision when he prophesied. He will stop wearing a hair cloak to deceive people. Many times people were dressing up a certain way to try to deceive people. You know, praise God, I just thought about that when we went to Florida last week. And some of the people I didn't even realize is on Facebook is part of my ex-husband's family. And so one lady, she says, you're a prophet? No, she says, I think she said, what are your title? I think it was. And I said, Dr. Neil, and I'm also a prophetess. And she said, what the Lord is saying to you about me? Now, I just met her. I said, nothing. I said, I'm not one of those lying prophets because someone said, give me a word of what the Lord is saying about me. I'm going to say something just to make you think I am who I said I am. I said, I fear the Lord. I'm not going to let him knock me down. But people will try you, and we have some people because that woman said, what's the Lord saying about you, about me? Oh, let me tell you, this is what the Lord said. Uh-oh, not me. I have the fear of God. If he didn't say anything about you, I'm not going to say anything about you. If he said something and told me to tell you, I will. Kind of remind me of my sister, Louise, here on Facebook. And I said, we had spoke about how certain things pastor says deceive people and it's not true. And I said, if the Lord tell me to correct something, I will. If he doesn't tell me, I'm not. So when the pastor said this, my sister did this to me, and then like, don't do it, sis, don't do it. And I said, if he told me, I would, but he didn't tell me, so I did not. So I'm not going to just do something because I did say if. I didn't say I would. I said, if the Lord tell me to correct something, I will, and I will. I said, but if he doesn't tell me, then I will not. But she was so afraid. No, sis, don't do it. Don't do it. Verse number 5. And instead he was saying, I'm no prophet. Number 1, the parents were supposed to stab their son to death if he kept lying and says that Adonai said. Remember the Lord said, the prophet would say something, and then they would say, Adonai said, when I said not. So here, because they was prophesying, and the parents stabbed him to death because of that, so now other people see this. Now listen to what he said. And instead he would say, I am no prophet. I just worked the soil. Since my youth, I only want to be an ordinary man. See, if you're just an ordinary man, then you're to be an ordinary man. Don't say the Lord called me to do this and he did not call me to do it or told me to say this and wear something so people think I'm who I said that I am. No, I'm to prove myself to no one. I am to obey my master. Hallelujah. If someone asks him, then what are these gashes between your shoulders? That means this one didn't die. He will answer, I got hurt at my friend's house. Notice how he lied. The gashes are where the parents tried to stab him to death, but he did not die. So when someone see all these gashes between his shoulder, he's going to lie and say, I got hurt at my friend's house. Not that my parents stabbed me, because I was prophesying lies and saying, Adonai said, awake, awake against my shepherd. Now when you read this, still in Zechariah chapter number 13. Awake, sword against my shepherd. Okay? Now, if you have your Bibles and you're studying your Bible, when you see awake sword against mine, that's God, shepherd, that's Yeshua. Because you go right back to Isaiah 53 and you study that. I have covered it before. Awake, awake against my shepherd, God, shepherd, Yeshua. Against the man who is close to me, because Yeshua was close to God. Says Adonai the oath. Strike the shepherd. Other words, God commanded them to strike the shepherd because Yeshua gave his life freely. Strike the shepherd and the sheep will be scattered. Now, if you do not believe this who is speaking of, you just go to Matthew 26 and verse number 31. Yeshua then said to them, tonight you will all lose faith in me. Now, notice these are disciples. They had faith in Yeshua. But Yeshua telling them, tonight, you all will lose faith in me. Letting us know we can have faith in Yeshua, but we can lose that faith. As the scripture says, going back, repeating what is written. As the scripture says, I will strike the shepherd. That's what God said. He was going to strike Yeshua. I will strike the shepherd dead, and the sheep of the flocks will be scattered. Well, that's what happened. You go to Mark 14:27. Yeshua said to them, you will all lose faith again in me, for the scripture says, I will strike, God will strike, the shepherd dead, Yeshua, and the sheep will be scattered, AMP. Jesus said to them, you will all fall away and be ashamed and be afraid to be associated with me as disciples, because it is written, I will strike the shepherd and the sheep will be scattered. Zechariah 13:8. In time throughout the land, says Adonai, 2/3 of those in it will be delivered. They will die, but 1/3 will remain. The third part I will bring through the fire. I will refine them as silver is refined. We covered that quite some time ago where I was teaching out some other verses and this reference came up. But this is very important. The third part I will bring through the fire, through testing. That's what that fire is, testing. I will refine them as silver is refined. going back to, we are being refined through testing. That means when we are tried, God is cleansing us. He wants to refine us as silver and gold. But in order to be refined as silver and gold, you got to stay on the potter's wheel. Because the scriptures speak of the potter's wheel. That's a place of refining. Well, what happens sometimes when God is refining us, seems like all hell break loose. Everything go bad. Like, I was doing so well before I tried to live for the Lord. As soon as I started trying to live for the Lord, like, all hell broke loose. I started losing my loved one. I lost my house. I lost my child. I lost this. I lost that. Because we are being refined. And that reminds me of my friend I had years ago when I was in Texas. Her name was Rosa. And I kept saying, Rosa, you want to go to church with me? And she said, no, Maddie. So one day she decided to go. She said, actually, this day I stopped asking her. And so she said, Mary, I'm going to church with you. I go, you are great. So Rosa went to church with me that Sunday. The next week, I called Rosa. Rosa came over. I can't remember. And I said, you going back to church with me? She said, no, Maddie. Before I went to church with you, everything was good. She said, but when I went to the church with you, someone broke in my car. I became sick and something else happened. I said, you're only being tried to see if you're going to continue to go. Do you know, I don't think she ever went back to church with me. So, when things start going bad, we are being refined. But it does not always feel good. But what God is doing, he's trying us as that silver and gold. He's purifying us. Because what happened when everything is going good, we follow him. And then when things start going, some of us should I say, then when things start going bad, you know what we say? God doesn't love me. If God loved me, why would this happen? That's not love. I think God really hates me. Have you ever heard people on TV and say, I hate him, and I don't go to church anymore. I don't read his word anymore, and they're cursing God out. Not knowing he's the one that can comfort you. He's the one that continue to bless you. He's the one that can give you more than what you lost before. Remember Job? How Job was persecuted? How Job went to the Lord and said, God is only blessing him because he have a head of protection. Just remove that head of protection and he will curse him to his face. Well, what happened? The Lord allowed Job to be tried because of that. The Bible said Job didn't do anything wrong. The Lord said, you moved me against Job when Job had done nothing wrong. So, because trials and temptation come, sometimes we haven't done anything wrong. But many times, it's because we're doing something wrong. And God is trying us because he want to get us out of a place to bring us to a better place. He want to get us out of the dungeon, out of Satan's hand, and put us in the hand of the Lord. So when you're in the hand of the Lord, you're going to be tried as long as you're in this earth. As long as you can make decisions for yourself. Because he's still what? Refining us. That we could come forth as what? Pure gold. No spots in our flesh. Because spots are sin when you study the Bible. No spot. That's why he said, I will what? Thoroughly cleanse my floor. And I only have a few more verses and I want to finish this. In time throughout the land, says Adonai, 2/3 of those in it will be destroyed. Some of us are going to be destroyed. They will die. Some of us are going to die spiritually. But 1/3 will remain, that the remnant. That third part I will bring through the fire. I will refine them as silver is refined. I will test them as gold is tested. They will call on my name. And I will answer them. I will say, this is my people. And they will say, Adonai is my God. Notice, They will call on my name. Remember, I always say that's the most powerful scripture I can find. Whosoever shall call upon the name of honor, now whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That word means shall be delivered. That means when we are going through something, God can deliver us. That's why he's able, people. He's able to deliver us. But in order for that to happen, we need to be followers of Yeshua the Messiah. Again, I pray that you study this for yourself. Read the Word of God. Do not just read verses. Trust me, when I share verses, I have read the whole chapter. I have studied the whole chapter. That's why the Bible says, study, show yourself approved, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. So once again, if you're not in the family of God, you're going to miss it. You cannot get in the family of God. You can't run a race unless you believe on God and believe that God raised his son, Yeshua the Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ, from the dead. If you just believe that, the same way your father Abraham was justified by his faith, we are justified by our faith, not by anybody else's faith. You must have faith. Believe in him. Believe on God. Believe he raised his son from the dead. And then once you're justified, that enter you into a race. Now you begin to run the race. There are so many other things that are required. That's why Romans 10 and 9 says, if we confess with our mouth, that means to speak, the Lord Yeshua, the Lord Jesus, and believe in our hearts, because everything is established by two witnesses, and believe in our hearts that God raised him, that's his son, Yeshua the Messiah, from the dead, thou shalt be saved. But out of the heart, remember, must become a stream of water. Just keep flowing. Out of the heart, man believeth, man continue to believe unto righteousness. And confession is made unto salvation. You keep confessing until you are delivered. Then when you go to Mark 6, Romans 10 and 13, whosoever shall call upon the name of honor and the name of the Lord shall be saved. Mark 16, 16, he that believeth, he that continue to believe and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. Proverbs 28 and verse 13, he that confesses and forsake, he that agree with God that sin is sin and repent shall have mercy. But he that confesses not and forsakes not his sin will not prosper. That's why 1 John 1 and 9 says, if. That means up to us. If we confess our sins, agree with God, sin is sin. He's faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from what? All unrighteousness. Going back, I will thoroughly cleanse my floor. So if you have not confessed Yeshua, repeat after me. I confess with my mouth the Lord Yeshua, the Lord Jesus, and I believe in my heart that God has raised him, Yeshua the Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ, from the dead. Once you confess that, remember, you are to confess that before men. That's why he said, if you confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father in heaven. But he also said, but if you deny me before men, I will deny you before my Father in heaven. Letting us know he will not confess us if we do not confess him. He's just not going to do it. That's why Simon Peter was the one that confessed him. He confessed that Yeshua was the Son of God. And Yeshua said, and thou art Simon Peter. He confessed the one that confessed him. Flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, but my Father in heaven. See, it's God the Father that revealed to us who Yeshua is. Yeshua teach us who his Father is. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you all. If you all are free, join us tomorrow night at 9 o'clock Eastern Time, 8 o'clock Central Time. And we are continuing to teach out of show and tell. Hallelujah. Bless you all in the name of Yeshua the Messiah. Father, we come once again in the name of your Holy Son. And God, we thank you for this opportunity to share your word. God, we thank you for each and every person that made it today. God, bless them in a special way. Give them that spirit of hunger and thirst, that they would eat your word, that they would receive your word, that they would obey your word in the name of Yeshua. Continue to bless them in their going in. Bless them in their coming out. Bless them in the city. Bless them in the field, because your word says, I will put my name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them. So I call you blessed in the name of Yeshua. Love you all with the love of Yeshua the Messiah. Hallelujah.